Open. Close.
Two.
Up.
All the way down. Open. Close.
Three.
Up. Down. Open. Close.
Four.
Up. Down. Open. Close.
Five.
Up.
Cause I'm in love with you. Money fall on you. Banana fall on you. Paparazzi follow you. Cause I'm in love with you. Are you done talking? Tell me, baby, are you done talking? Yeah. Are you done talking? Tell me, baby, are you done talking? Yeah. Are you done talking? Tell me, baby, are you done talking? Yeah. Are you done talking? Tell me, baby, are you done talking? Yeah. I don't wanna be a player no more. Yeah. I don't wanna be a player no more.
Hello and welcome to our channel. HNJ Fit Muslima. This is my husband
James,
and I'm Hafsat Maina Muhammad, and we'll be taking you through another episode of my workout, because we're trying to get this mommy belly under control, right, baby? So we're trying to get it under control and get me fit and healthy. So if you've been following us, please keep following us. Subscribe, like, and comment. You can also ask questions about what you see us doing today or in the previous videos, and we'll be happy, happy to answer. So, trainer, hubby, what are we doing today?
Well, as you can see, I am very tired. Had a very long day. You see how dedicated I am to this. And even though I'm tired, I have an extremely long day tomorrow. I am here. So, by me having to be so tired, it's time for her to feel like I feel.
What?
And to also know how it feels after. Because I had a good workout today, too. As you can see, I stay buff. Mm. So, now, it's her turn. Now, as you all can know, is that this is not proctored or anything of this nature, that she has never done a deadlift. Never. And as you can see down here, these are dimes, and this is a nickel. So this will be a total of, we're not going to count the bar. I think that might be a pound. We don't count that. So we're going to count the weight. So it's 50 pounds.
Oh, wow.
So she would learn it. She would be learning today how to do a deadlift with 50 pounds. And then after that, we're going to follow with some standing Arnold presses, which she has never done this exercise before either. So you get to see how she learned, as well as how she may struggle, may have some criticism, may give me some looks that I don't see, but it's all okay. So now, we're going to begin with no warm-up, because I'm assuming she can lift 50 pounds. We have babies, so, and I'm sure Ayan weighs at least 50 pounds. So, what we're going to do is, this is not an Olympic bar, just a body bar, so we're going to walk up as close to the bar as we can.
I tell my kid.
And at that point in time, see how she's already standing, like she's comfortable in a squat. That's the perfect position. The deadlift can be a very dangerous exercise, so I want to make sure that I cue her correctly. Now, do you remember the squat that we taught you how to sit in that chair? I want you to squat down like that. Now, but I want you to keep your heels on the floor. There you go. Now, put your hands on the bar. Now, at that point, chest up, her head is up, her legs are down. Now, I want you to stand straight up, keeping your arms straight with the bar in your hand. Stand up, and perfect. Now I want you to give me 12 reps like that. Back down. And back up. Now, as we can see, she's squatting down to the floor. Now I would do a little correcting, a little cue. Oh, she almost caught on just like that. She don't need to go down to the floor. She might be a natural at this. That's three. Okay. Now, there's a four. Keep your arms straight. Your arms stay straight. And there's a couple of other things that she would be doing wrong that I'm about to correct on. Five, arms stay straight. Arms stay straight the whole time.
I can't put my arms straight.
Like that. Just like that. Just like that.
But they hurt more.
Okay, well, but this is the exercise. Seven. You have way more support with your traps, your shoulders. Eight. Now, the only thing I will ask her to do at this point in time is make sure the bar stays closer to her legs. That way she don't put so much stress on her lower back. Also, for all y'all women out there, we know that this can be a booty exercise.
11. I don't need no more booty.
So we're working for the lower back. 12. Good job. I will have to give her, that's for the first time, and she's banging on the floor, which we will work with later. But That is good for a first time. Now we're going to do standard arm presses. Now, I'm not demonstrating exercise. I am letting her demonstrate the exercise as well as performing. So we're going to do 12. Again, our number's going to be 12. Okay, now I want you to stand up and make, like you have your arms out like this, like you're performing a T. Okay. Now, I want you to bring your arms in like you're about to hug something. Take them back out and then press in the air. That'll be one. We want 12, just like that. These are called Arnold presses, but we're standing. The reason why we're standing, because today I want her to focus a lot on her core so she can have a stronger core as well as stronger back.
Out.
No, not out, just up.
Okay, up.
Down.
Down.
Hug.
Hug.
Up. And then back out. Go back out.
Back out.
And up.
Zara
four.
Is laughing at me.
There we go again. No, there you go.
Okay.
Press.
Press.
Five. Down.
Mm-hmm.
Turn.
Turn.
Out. Up. Here we go.
Down.
All the way in. Turn your palms towards you.
Yep.
Back
press.
Out.
Out.
And press up. Good. I think we're at eight now. We're going to do four more.
Huh?
Four more. No more. The waist, we still using 5 pounds on the waist. I have some more dumbbells. I have another 10-pound dumbbell in our basement. As well as I have some very surprising dumbbells in the trunk of my car. To let you know what they are a 15-pound dumbbells, they are 20-pound dumbbells, and I have some 25s too.
Who's going to use it?
Yeah, she's going to use it. That's when we come with the dumbbell squats, we come with the dumbbell deadlifts. We're going to be mixing it up for you all.
Yeah, I just messed up here, but I guess I did.
And Wednesday, that's 12. Now remember, like I told you, we always want her to do some type of cardiovascular exercise. So now, what I have planned for her today is, we're going to have her to jump. So, we're going to now, to make it more interesting, to make sure that she is jumping, we're going to keep her behind the bar. So I want you all to look to make sure when she jump up in the air, we ain't worrying about her touching that. She don't have a vertical of 30 inches. So, we want her to jump, but make sure at least... See, I want you all viewers to comment to see if her feet ever come over the bar like this as she's jumping in the air. And she's going to do this for 15, but I wanted to do them fast. Like she's a cheerleader. No. I want you to turn like this because we don't want you to think you're jumping
like
over
this.
The bar. Now, and I want you to jump up in the air and 15 times as fast as you can, as high as you can. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Hey, that isn't bad at all. Okay, now she get only a 90-second break.
Do I get a cookie?
No, no cookies.
What's worth the try?
She's been asking. Cookies, she's been asking for chips, she's been asking.
No, but you know what?
For potatoes.
I'm asking because it just eases the, you know, diet thing. And... I've been really trying. I think I deserve a cookie.
60 more seconds.
It was our thing, so right, Zara?
Only the babies deserve cookies, and I deserve cookies.
What?
And the reason why I deserve cookies is because I have to be able to feed these muscles.
I got muscles too to feed.
Now, for all you all that know fitness, we know that cookies are not good, literally, for feeding muscles. But in my situation, with a very fast metabolic rate, I can eat cookies because I like junk calories to try to maintain my weight because it's the easiest calories.
What does that mean? Like junk calories?
Meaning calories that really don't have much use for the body, but they have some type of use for the body. Because I do use the carbohydrates, I do use the fat to restore glycogen, and also to bring my calories up for the day. Because I try to consume at least between 5,000 and 7,000 calories a day. Okay, that's your time. Okay,
ouch.
Now, 12 deadlifts. Now, I'm going to take a knee right here while I'm watching her and pretending like I'm not seeing her, but really watching to make sure she don't get hurt. Because we do want her to be able to do this on her own sometimes when I just come in the house and I can just go to bed and knowing that she already got her workout in. Hey, we're not looking too bad so far. Next time we have her do these deadlifts, I'm going to have to add 20 more pounds to
her. Six. No.
So then we'll be up to 70 pounds. I like adding weight. Weight is a good thing. And for all you all, for all... So she did very good for that set. Now we're back to our third and final set. She went right into it. As you can see, she's motivated. I like that. Good attitude about this. So now, as we can see, this deadlift has gotten a lot better. She's keeping it closer to her body, which is good. I couldn't ask for a better performance from a beginner.
Am I done yet?
No. You supposed to be counting. Was you counting 12?
Yes.
Well, what number you on?
10.
Oh, see? I counted 8, though. If you were counting,
I was 12.
Okay, I guess she's not going to
You are not going to cheat me this time.
Okay, now
around.
We got to pick up the dumbbells. No. I'll stand in Arnold's.
Okay. So if I remember, it is.
No. No. Straight up in the air like you're about to make a T.
Yeah.
There you go. Up, down, come all the way around like you're hugging. Palms turn you. Remember, your palms always finish towards you. Now back out. Okay. All the way back out. Press up again. That is one. Good. That's the first perfect one she's done without me having to tell her to turn her palm. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Laughing at mommy?
Yeah, she is.
10.
Okay. I can feel my arms burning.
11. And she has one more. And then remember them jumps, you all. This is what she have to do. Watch that bar. See if she ever get over that bar.
12.
But this time I had to do a little correcting with her because I told her that I actually want her to get them hips down and then jump in the air. Get them hips down, then jump in the air. That's how we're working this time. Get them hips down and jump in it. We're trying to get her from, instead of jumping from her toes, to pretend like she's back in Nigeria trying to jump over a fence again. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. 11. And 12. Good. And now she's going to get a brief break. We're going to do 90 seconds again because we're actually speeding things up today because I do want to grab some grub, get some sleep. I have to get up at 4 o'clock, have an early morning client, long day, which I'm going to love once I get my hands on them. So now what we want to do while she's taking her break, what we're going to do now is what I'm going to call a speed blitz. So it's going to be three rounds with no breaks.
Whoa.
The reason why, so the first one she's going to do a lunge, and then a jump. A lunge, then a jump. So that's then she's going to be 12 of them. Then after that, she's going to get down. Then she's going to do what I like to call gates, but you would notice that it would be up, down, open, close. She come up 6 inches, she go open, then she close. Then after that, she go back down, but she never touches the ground.
Okay, this sounds like a death sentence.
So then after we're going to do 3 sets of them.
Don't ignore me.
Fast.
Do not ignore me.
Then we're going to be done for tonight.
Don't ignore me. That sounds like a death sentence.
Well, it's definitely going to get her heart rate up. That's for sure. So the first one is going to be, she's going to be lunge. Then she's going to step back. Then she's going to lunge. Then after that, she's going to jump.
Okay.
Then back down. See, I can jump. Oh, I have a broken hip. I can still jump.
Oh, please.
Okay, now. So let's go. We're going to lunge. That's the first demonstration y'all seen me do. Okay, good. Lunge. Lunge. Back. Jump. One. Back into the lunge again. Then you lunge. Lunge. And jump. Two. Okay. Lunge. And lunge. Get your hands off it. And jump. There you go. Move your hands off.
I cannot. I cannot even cheat a little.
Get them handles. Cheating don't get results. Three. Lunge. Lunge. Let's see how she cheated on the lunge again. Four. Remember, we want her to get down in the lunge.
Open. Close.
Two.
Up.
All the way down. Open. Close. Three. Up. Down. Open. Close. Four. Up. Down. Open. Close. Five. Up. Up.
I can't.
Down.
Close.
Hey, good. Rest. Back up.
From her loving husband, into which you can see she's standing like she got the pose now, like she's a workout junkie. So now we get to turn up the volume even more.
You know what? It's a wrap. And I sure hope you would subscribe, like, and comment, and ask questions, and follow our workout and my journey. Stay tuned and forget about the cute voices you hear behind. It's all
money follow you. Banana follow you. Brother follow you. Cause I'm in love with you. Money fall on you. Banana fall on you. Paparazzi follow you. Cause I'm in love with you.
If I offend you,
if I offend you, because sorry, oh baby, take a toe. Sorry, oh baby, take a toe.
I'm in love with you.
I'm in love with you. Oh baby, nothing of it to change amo. Nothing of it to change amo.
If I talk, then go say I dey talk. Yeah. Tell me why then they use Panadol for our headache. Yeah. How I go chop if my baby no chop? They want to spoil our market. Yeah. I don't wanna be a player no more.